Welcome to Unleashed, a TRICOM podcast that delves into the topics that impact your business, from leadership to teamwork and personal development. All are essential components to any successful organization. Our goal is to provide valuable insight, inspire, and motivate individuals for personal and professional growth while promoting self-reflection and a growth mindset by sharing practical tools and resources. Today, we wanted to start with a powerful influence of attitude on our lives, from the way we perceive challenges to how we interact with others. Attitude shapes our experiences and determines the outcomes we achieve. Attitudes can positively and negatively impact our team performance. Joining me today is Amanda Jadro, TRICOM's Director of Credit. Hello, Amanda.
Hello.
Thanks for joining me.
Yeah, it's nice to be here with you, Julie.
Yes, I'm excited about this. So both you and I recently read John Maxwell's book, Attitude 101, correct?
That's right.
I love his series. So let me give you just a quick synopsis of John Maxwell. He is a number one New York Times bestseller author and speaker who has sold more than 24 million books in 50 languages. Maxwell is one of the most popular leadership experts in the world. Join us as we explore the mindsets behind attitudes, share some of our experiences as how both positive and negative attitudes can impact our team's performances, and finally provide practical strategies to develop a great attitude and steps on how to change bad habits into good ones. So let's delve in right away. Amanda, tell me, what have you noticed, you know, with it, with an attitude within staff, on yourself, within your own team?
Sure. Yeah. Attitude is really a driving force between their performance and the outcomes that they are able to achieve. It's within everyone, and it's a constant. So it's something that's really important to make sure that you have a positive attitude to help reach those outcomes that you're looking to achieve.
Don't you feel that sometimes, I mean, I think it's really critical that leaders don't ignore attitude with people, that they really don't ignore bad attitudes within a team. And
absolutely.
I think we've all done that. I know for myself, we've done it, where you've got a great performer, phenomenal performer, but somebody that comes in with a bad attitude all the time. But you're like, you know, I don't want to get rid of that person. They're such a great performer.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
It's hard.
It is. And, you know, it's really important to address bad behavior. And if there's an attitude that is, you know, kind of affecting someone, it's affecting the entire team.
Right.
So, you know, once you have, you know, kind of that attitude in that department, the entire team's performance will decrease. And when the attitude is positive, their entire performance is going to increase and you'll see much better results.
Right.
So it might be a difficult thing to work on, but it's something that you have to address, because if you don't, it's not going to go away on its own. It will just continue to be there and fester and, you know, kind of affect that team.
Definitely. I think we've experienced that over the years and learned from those mistakes of not addressing that situation where you've got a great performer that can't change that attitude, that doesn't have it within themselves to learn from those behaviors that we'll talk about later in one of these episodes of how do you take a bad attitude and work toward a good attitude and what are the stepping stones or what tools you can use to make yourself get into a better attitude. But there are people that just for some reason can't, and it's an infectious, almost like a cancer that gets in within a team, right?
Absolutely. And, you know, as much as you want to help someone in that situation, you can provide tools, you can help them, try to coach them through the way that they're looking at things, the way they're perceiving things, to try and help them reshape their own attitude. But you can't make somebody do it who doesn't want to do it.
Right.
So, you know, that there's going to be a limitation on how much you can help someone.
What's always shocked me is when that person finally is removed from the department, we always are like, no, we can't get rid of them, we can't get rid of them. And then we remove them. And the whole department changes.
Mm-hmm.
And what we thought was going to be so difficult turns around to be like a success story.
Absolutely.
The team comes together, the team builds up,
mm-hmm.
they're like, they rally, and it actually is a win for the entire organization, especially for the team.
It is, you know, and people rise to the occasion. You give them an opportunity, and for those that did not particularly like having that atmosphere, When that changes, it gives them an opportunity to rise up and to kind of make that environment what they want it to be, and to, you know, get those tasks done and maybe learn new things that they didn't have the opportunity to do.
Right. Let's talk about the positive attitude people, those people that walk in all the time. They're like, where do you ever get that energy that you seem like you never have a bad day? Mm-hmm. I have a bad day, and I have to change those sometimes. You know, you realize, okay, I'm having a bad day. What do I got to do to change it? But some people always seem so positive. But you love those in your organization.
You do. Yeah. And, you know, something that is part of your personality. Mm-hmm. There's different personality traits. And some people tend to have maybe more negativity in their just natural traits that they have. And others are much more easygoing and are able to adapt differently and quicker. Mm-hmm. So those are the people that just, I think, have a natural behavior.
They can control their feelings. Yeah. They've learned how to control their feelings.
They have.
They have. They really have. I think John Maxwell talks about where he says, changing your mindset from I have to do it to I get to do it. You know, just saying I get to do this every day. You know, like I get to go to work every day, because there's a lot of people that aren't able to work either because of the handicap or whatever, or maybe they're medical reasons, or maybe they're in a country where they don't have that ability. So it's really changing your mindset, and that's really what attitude's about, correct?
Absolutely. Yeah. No, I agree 100%. It's looking for the opportunity, you know, in that challenge, because there's always an opportunity if you're willing to look for that. Mm-hmm. So, you know, those things that might feel burdensome, those are your biggest opportunities to grow, and having that growth mindset will help you get through those, and you'll feel like you've accomplished something at the end of that task, even though it may have been challenging in the beginning.
I think that's really great. Instead of the day beating you, you beating the day. And what are you going to achieve today? So it's really interesting how attitude can set you up for success or for failure, I really believe.
Yeah, it's true. And, you know, some of the things that John Maxwell talks about is this principle of the slight edge. So it is just the small little thing that you do differently that helps you be successful. Mm-hmm. And just to remember that it only takes that little bit of difference to really be impactful.
Right. And the other thing was life is the influences. What you become, you know, in 5 years will be determined by what you read and what you associate with. So the influences in your life, so setting your mindset today and will be determined what you are looking like in 5 years. And I really believe that. Again, it's about attitude and pushing those things. And even when challenges do come up, how do you approach those challenges? Are you approaching them as an opportunity or as I guess how people look at it as a negative, as this is a defeat or as a challenge? Mm-hmm. More. I always try to, when we talk about it here a lot, these are opportunities. Mm-hmm. Here's an opportunity we have. And so this is a problem. Yeah. And I think that's what has helped us, TRICOM, as we've gone through the 30 plus years, as we face different things, is here's an opportunity. And it's really a mindset so that people can get behind things instead of being like, oh, it's a problem. When you say problem, immediately it's a negative, negative tone to it, I believe.
Yeah, absolutely. You got to look at the positive. What is the opportunity in the situation? If you can focus on those things and just understand that difficult problems, difficult times will happen in everyone's life. It's part of life. It's part of the journey. And it's okay. It makes you stronger at the end. Mm-hmm. And you're going to learn from a lot of different mistakes that you have made in life. And, you know, there really isn't a true mistake, because it's an opportunity to learn from it. So as long as you have those kinds of mindsets, I feel it makes you stronger and better at the end. And, you know, even more importantly, just keep in mind, people are watching you. People are, kind of assessing your character on how you were able to get through some of these situations. And many people are going to look to certain individuals to help kind of mentor them through difficult times, and they're going to emulate some of the things that they've seen other people do in a positive way and try to be more like them. So there's lots of good things that can come from challenge.
It's so interesting you say people are watching you, because that's my biggest thing. A couple things came to mind on that. So the way my office sits, I can see everybody that walks in the door, both interviewees, people are coming in to interview for the company, and staff. And it's funny how I watch people, how they carry themselves when they walk in the door. I can tell if they're going to have a great day, if they're in a great mood, and an interviewee, if that's a person that we want to hire or not. Just how they carry themselves through the door, how they walk. And it's really interesting. And I've talked to supervisors about, like, assistant managers or people that we call up and coming, mm-hmm. and going, yeah, they really have the technical skill. Mm-hmm. But as a leader, I can't see them leading the team because they don't carry themselves with this. They're down, their head's down, mm-hmm. they're slumping, they're walking the pace and all that. Yep. And that's all the attitude, because that's portraying out to their team.
Right.
So their team is reading that. That's all. I mean, I feel that. Mm-hmm. And so I always tell that to people. I'm like, oh, I just saw that interview come in. They're not going to be successful. Did you see how they walk? They walk really slow. Their head was down. Their shoulders shrugged forward. I really believe that the way you carry yourself is a lot to say about your attitude and how you're going to approach things in life and at the job.
Yeah, no, and it's true. And people are not able to get along with people well, mm-hmm. when they've got this kind of cloud hanging over them, where they maybe feel like, they've had a difficult day or a difficult situation happen. The rest of us can feel that.
Right, right. And we're not saying that we all have bad days and we have a situation. We've all gone through some type of bad season in our life. I'll call it a terrible season. It's how you take that season and go with it that season, I guess, is my message. Is you'll have a few days and now you have to go regroup and go, okay, I'm in a bad season. And now how do I take that season and move forward with it? Am I going to take it and be a victim, or am I going to take it and learn from that and really take it and move forward and say, okay, I'm going to be a better person, a bigger person. I'm going to take all of it and take learning opportunities from that. Mm-hmm. And that's, I think, all about attitude again.
It is. You know, one of the definitions that John Maxwell uses in the book about attitude, which I feel is very fitting, just says it's the inward feelings expressed by behavior. And this is the way an attitude can be seen without saying a word. And I think you've talked a little bit about that too, just by the way people carry themselves, is you can see their attitude even though they have not said anything to you.
Right.
Their body language is that mm-hmm. strong. And attitude is more honest and more consistent than your words are.
Right, right. And I think it's hard for people to realize that your body really does share a lot, say a lot about your attitude.
Yeah.
Excellent. That's good. Well, I think we hit on some really great points here today.
Yeah.
The book is phenomenal. I thought it was great. I love all his books,
yes.
The ones that we've read. We're going to have some more comments on his books. And, of course, we want to come back to some really important things on attitude. Any closing points you want to talk about?
You know, my final comment here is just a quote from President Thomas Jefferson, which I really loved in the book.
Okay.
It says, "Nothing can stop a man with the right mental attitude from achieving his goals. Nothing on earth can help a man with the wrong mental attitude." So it just shows you how powerful and strong attitude is. And knowing that that's something that you can control, it should be very empowering to everyone who is trying to achieve some specific goals in their lives.
That's great. No, that's really good. Mine was, attitude presents a difficulty in every opportunity. For others, it presents an opportunity in every difficulty. It's your perspective. It's really your perspective on how you look at things. And so I think that's what our closing comments are for the group today.
Yes.
So I'd like to thank you, Amanda Jadro, for joining me today and sharing your thoughts and your experiences on attitude, as well as each of you for tuning in. Join us on our next episode as we explore the power of positive attitude and we discuss ways to shifting from a negative to a positive attitude. Thank you again for listening, and don't miss our next episode.